Why is the world so messed up today? They have so much knowledge today. Why can't they fix things? Why has everything been destroyed? In the beginning, when we were created in the image of God, we had God's nature in us. And we didn't have lust in us. But then we ate of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And then we lusted after the flesh, all wanting to do our own will. We became like animals, predators in this world. And it took so many years to reach this point. They could renew themselves for thousands of years, even after all their wars and destruction and diseases. But then after the Industrial Revolution and man's knowledge increased so much, Daniel, the prophet, the angel told him, Gabriel told him, said, in the last days, knowledge would increase and that people would be running to and fro, back and forth. And who could have ever imagined that they would have this much knowledge and be running back and forth as much as they are today? And yet they can't fix anything. They're all out of order. They're all in disarray. Why? Because they've lost contact with their creator. Now, when God lost us to Lucifer in the garden, he made a way for us to come back to partake of the tree of life. And that was through his son, Jesus Christ, who was the holy seed born of the Holy Spirit. And then after Jesus made the sacrifice and the resurrection, he sent the gift of the Holy Spirit, which regenerates us into the sons and daughters of God. And that's God back in us. We have the nature of God in us. We hear his voice. We do his will. We call it the Comforter. He comforts me all the time. He tells me that he loves me and that he's with me and everything is going to be all right. But I don't get that from reading scriptures that he told somebody else. That's like spoken. When Jesus would speak a word to somebody, that was to them. It was spirit and life. But when you take that word, claim it, somebody else claims it, it's not to them. It doesn't have the spirit in it. It's not Jesus speaking that to them. And so religion has failed. They with religion, when they compiled the Bible and authorized the Bible, they diverted people from the Holy Spirit into the Bible. And now they're searching for God in the scriptures instead of in the spirit where he can be found. Jesus is a living, resurrected Savior and King. And he leads us and guides us by his spirit, not by the Bible. There's 45,000 different Bible denominations. And there's so many other religions in the world. They have their books too. And they're all fighting and disagreeing one with another. Because why? They have the same fallen nature. They all want their will. They all think they're right through knowledge. They have knowledge. They're eating from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So they're thinking they're good and the other people are evil. But the knowledge of good and evil does not reconcile you back to God. It doesn't give you the nature of God. Children, you need to repent from living after the flesh and quit trying to serve God through knowledge. You've got to partake of the tree of life. You need to ask Jesus to fill you with the Holy Spirit and then be led by the Holy Spirit only. The Bible can give you knowledge, but knowledge will not save you. You have to live by faith, and not faith in knowledge, faith in the living God through Jesus Christ. And he leads you by the Spirit. That's why the world is in such a mess and they can't fix it now. They've gone so far. Harlan and I used to think that God was going to destroy the earth, but God doesn't have to destroy the earth. They've destroyed it themselves. There's so much trouble in the world right now that they keep trying to put band-aids on it and fix it, but they're just making it worse. They're not going to be able to fix it. The only hope any of us have is to get in the Holy Spirit. And that is our only hope. God sent the gift of the Holy Spirit to us. He said, in the last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And he will write his laws in our hearts and in our minds. He will lead us and guide us. The Gentiles that don't have the law, they do by nature the things contained in the law. This is a real truth. You can't get it from the Bible. You have to go to the living Jesus Christ. Ask him to fill you with the Holy Spirit. Jesus has shook hands with me. He was with me today. He was with me last night and yesterday. He speaks to my heart all the time. He comforts me. He heals me. He leads me. He guides me. He shows me what to do and what not to do. I know it by nature. Sometimes he speaks it to my heart, sometimes in dreams and visions. And sometimes I just know because Christ is in me by the Spirit. And you can have this too. It's for everyone. It's not a matter of your righteousness. You have to come to him. Christ is our only righteousness. Jesus puts his spirit in us, and that is our righteousness. We are incapable of doing the will of God without Christ in us. And Christ in us will give us the power to do it, and he will do the will of God. I hope you guys understand that you can't fix this problem. And the only way you're going to get in him is through the Holy Spirit, which is the gift and promise of God to us. So I pray that you will stop searching for God in the scriptures and start searching for him with your heart, where your breath of life is, and start looking to him. God wants us to worship him in the spirit and truth. While the spirit is truth, the Bible's not truth. There's some recorded truth in there, but it's misinterpreted. Everybody interprets it to their own destruction. Everybody thinks they're right. And then a lot of people, they think that they know, but you don't see the fruits of the spirit in them. They don't have the love of Christ. They don't have compassion. They don't have the spirit of truth in them. They have all their great knowledge, and that won't save you, children. I'm telling you the truth because this has been revealed to us, to this generation. And the Lord is speaking to you through me to tell you that you need to get in the spirit, and this is no game. Come to the living God with your heart, and then you will find life and stay with him the rest of your life. In Jesus' name, Yeshua, in the spirit. It is a real gift from God, and you will know it when he fills you up, because you'll have a different, when he fills you with the spirit, you'll have a different nature in you. You won't be attracted to the world, and you won't be attracted to fleshly things. You'll be attracted to your creator. I pray you all find this life in Christ.
I started out for Jesus Christ to run, full of joy and love for the good life. Heartaches, pain, and Satan kept on coming to preach these words of life. There is a prize. Don't give up, don't give up, keep on trying. Don't give up, don't give up, men are dying. Keep on crying. Don't give up, keep on.